Hello, welcome to a new Photoshop tutorial. I'm Andre from PSD Box, and today I'm going to talk a bit about 3D objects and how to add textures in Photoshop and basically show you how to use the 3D objects that I upload here on this website, which is resources.psdbox.com. If you don't know this website, it's one of my websites that I have, and here you have lots of stock images, brushes, presets, textures, actions, and that kind of stuff. I wanted to separate this from psdbox.com, so I created the separate website. And here I started to upload a few 3D objects, and I will upload more and more. And these are 3D objects that you can use in Photoshop. Now, you need a Photoshop version that supports 3D objects. And in my case, I'm using Photoshop CC, which supports 3D objects. And I want to show you how you can use these objects, which you can download from my website. Usually, I include PNG renders. So if you download a pack, like for example, this one, you includes 4 PNG in high resolution with transparent backgrounds. But I also give you the 3D object, which you can use and render yourself in Photoshop. And I want to show you how to use them. For example, let's download this one. You can see the size of this object is pretty high because of the PSD file. It takes lots of space. And let me download this one so I can show you how you can use this. I'm going to save this right over there and wait for the download to finish. Okay, so once you download that, you will see inside the pack you have the PNG renders, which I rendered myself. And you can just use this right away. These are in PNG format with different angles, and this one are without background. And also here you'll find the 3D files. In this case, I also include the Blender file, and also the PSD file with the Photoshop file. So just double click on that. And if your Photoshop supports 3D, you will just open the file and that's it. And then go to the 3D tab. And you don't even have to change the textures because this is already applied the textures on it. The only thing you have to change is the light. If you don't like that, or if you want to have different kind of lighting, you can use the infinite light, which comes by default. Soften the shadows. I have Photoshop in Spanish right now, so sorry about that. But basically here, when you select the light, you have these two options on the properties panel. And you can, if you don't see it, usually it's somewhere here on the window. Just choose properties and that's it. And you can soften the shadows here, you can add more lights. For example, I could make this, if I want to make a night scene, I could darken this a lot and use a bluish tone like this. And then add a point light with a new point light. That's my Photoshop runs slow right now. So just add my point light over here. Let's select the point light and move it. Just rotate this around using this controls here on the bottom. And just put your light right over there. Okay, and you can see the shadow reacting to my light. Now, I have my light over there. Let's say I want to have a candle or something. I can drop the intensity a little bit, change the color of it. And once you're done customizing all of this, the lighting and all of that, let's zoom in now. I can even disable the ground plane if I want. Here on the ground, you can turn that off if you don't want it. If you want to have your own ground, you can disable this. Okay. Well, this actually only disables the material. Now I can just click render over here and wait for Photoshop to render the scene. The higher the resolution of your document, the longer it takes for Photoshop to render this. You will see it here on the bottom left. In just a second, you will see a progress bar here, and it will tell you how much it takes to render this scene. Maybe in this case, about 15 or 20 minutes. And you can see Photoshop starts to calculate shadows and all of that. And that's how you can use this. Just open that, rotate around, match the angle that you want for your manipulation or your project, add the light that you want or change the light properties and render the file, and that's it. Usually I render files in Blender, and now I want to show you how I use this. For example, let's download a new file. For example, let's see. this one over here. I think I already downloaded this file. You'll find the link on the video description if you want to download this. It's free to download. And let's see where it is inside the 3D folder. Orcish helmet. Let's unzip this. And basically, if you don't want to see this, you can. The tutorial is over. I just wanted to show you how you can use the 3D objects that I upload on my website. But if you want to see how you can add the textures to an object yourself, keep watching. Okay. So I want to download this object and I want to use it in Photoshop. So basically, what you would do is just download the file, and you'll find usually the textures folder, which include several textures and maps to create the 3D effect, and the source, which is the object itself plus the textures again. Now, Photoshop supports several kinds of 3D objects, and here on the Adobe side, you will see if you just type 3D Photoshop formats, here you'll find the supported 3D formats. 3D Studio, it's the 3DS format, and the Waveform object. Usually, I use this ones. So let's say I want to download this shield and use it in Photoshop in 3D format. Now, this is a free download, and you will find the link on the video description if you want to download and try it yourself. And when you click download, you will see that you can see the file format here, and sometimes you can see FBX. Just click download and just download it on your computer, and after you download it, you will find, let's unzip this. Usually you'll find the textures, and the good thing about this 3D object that you download from sketchfab.com is that they are already UV unwrapped. And this is the OBJ 3D file, and here we have the textures. Now, if you have an FBX format, you will not be able to import that in Photoshop. And what I do is I use Blender for that. It's a free program which is available for Windows and Mac. I'm not a Blender user. I don't know how to use that. I don't know how. I'm not good at modeling, but I know how to import my objects in here and then export it into a format that Photoshop supports. I'm going to show you really quick how to do that. I'm going to create a new file. Usually you get this when you open Blender. Just select that cube with right click, press X, delete, and then go to File, Import, and choose FBX. In my case, I'm going to choose OBJ because this is an OBJ format, which I could already import into Photoshop, but I just want to show you the process. So let's suppose this is an FBX format. Just drag it in there, choose Import, and this is your object. With the mouse wheel, you can zoom in and out. If you press S, you will be able to scale this down. And you can move this up and down. Okay, so once you have your object here, it's just a matter of going back to File and choose Export, and select Waveform OBJ. Click that, give it a name, export it, and that's it. And then you'll be able to import that in Photoshop. Now let's see how to import this into Photoshop once you have it exported as an OBJ format. Now, if you have Photoshop open, you can simply drag it in here, and that's it. You'll choose the size for it, for your canvas, and click OK. Keep in mind that the bigger the canvas size, the longer it takes for Photoshop to render. And here we have the object. Now, I'm going to show you how to apply those textures to it. First, I want to change the light. This infinite light, it's coming from the front, which I don't want. It's better to have it on the side so you can see the textures better. And here, when you switch the 3D workspace, you'll have the 3D tab on the layers palette here. And we have the scene, the environment, the camera that we already, which is this view over here, the camera. And we have the object itself, which is illustrated by this cylinder here, which we can expand. And here we can see all the materials that this object has. In this case, it's really simple, so we only have one material. But if you have a complex object, you might have several materials here. And for each of these materials, you should have a set of textures. Usually we have four. We have the albedo or base color or simply color. We have the glossiness or roughness or metallic actually. And we have the normal map, which gives us the 3D effect. And then the specular, which we're not going to use in Photoshop. And it's just a matter of knowing where to put these textures in Photoshop. Let's see how we can do this. First, we're going to start select the material, and we're going to start with the diffusion. I still have this in Spanish. I forgot to change it, but anyways. You'll find this on each of these sliders. You'll see this folder icon, which indicates there's no texture applying right now, except for the diffusion, which has this file icon. This is just a fill color, this gray color, which you can change. But let's add the texture. Click here, choose replace texture. And this is the last folder that I use. What I'm going to do is Control Tab, select the texture and drag it into this file explorer. And this will open that folder and click open. And voila, you have the texture on the object. If the object is not UV unwrapped, it's not going to look like this. So if you see something really weird, you either chose a wrong texture or the object is not UV unwrapped. In order to see if it's UV unwrapped, you can click here and choose edit texture. This will open a PSB file and you can see the UV mesh here. And the texture is perfectly aligning to those, the mesh. Okay, next we have to create the 3D and the metallic look on this texture. So let's use the other maps. Let's start with the normal, which is the easiest one. And it's really easily recognizable by this really weird colors here. And usually has the normal name on it or OpenGL or something like that. And you have to put it here on the bottom where it says normal. Click the folder icon, click. You can also generate normals from the diffusion map. If you don't have the normal map, but you have the diffusion, Photoshop can create the normal map for you. But since we already have it, let's load it. Click here. Now the folder is the last one that I used. So I'm going to open that and check the shield. You can see the 3D effect. If you didn't see, just go back and replay the video and you will see how we created this texture on the 3D effect on it. Next, we have the glossiness. The glossiness in Spanish, well, it's this one over here, but they don't work always. So let's see if that works now. Glossiness, open it, and you have to increase this to 100% because it already have the gloss information on it. And then we have the specular. Here you see specular. Load, specular map, click load, but it's not always working. So I don't know why, but the specular maps don't work the same. I don't know if I put it wrong here, but they not always work. If you have an ambient occlusion, which is very usual here with the objects that you download from Sketchfab or other websites like CG Trader or other websites, the ambient occlusion should be placed here, where I think it in English it's environment or something like that. In this case, Photoshop cannot create the map for you, so you have to load it and look. It's usually a map. Let me show you like how it looks like. The ambient occlusion usually looks like this. Now this is the you don't have an ambient occlusion map there. Treasure chest. Okay, this is how an ambient occlusion map would look like. Something really weird, just black and white, but there. Use less and less every time because ambient occlusions, I think they are calculated automatically, but I don't know. Okay, so this is how you can texture an object. This was really simple, but if you have multiple materials, you should have a set of, I think it was this one, you should have a set of textures for each material. In this case, just one face. We can rotate this around. You can see the texture looks good. Now, the next step is the lighting. By default, Photoshop creates this. You can see the metallic and the normal map. Check the texture here on the side, how the texture interacts with the light and creates this sort of fake shadow and bumps on the texture. Okay, so that's achieved with those materials that we just put there. You can create as many lights as you want. You can soften their shadows. If you don't want to have shadows on the ground, let's create a new layer so you can see it better. I'm going to create a blank layer and fill it with white. Okay, if you don't want to see this shadow over here, let's deactivate the ground plane as well. Go to View, Show, and choose Ground Plane. And if you don't want to see the shadow over here, you should go to Environment, I think it's called here, and just drop the opacity of the shadow of the ground plane to 0, and that's it. Okay, and now you can create multiple lights. We need the lights because otherwise we will not have any shadows and would be really flat. Okay, so let's create a new light, a point light maybe. And after you add the new light on there, just move it around. Change the intensity, you can even change the color of it if you want, like that. Okay, and when you're done, just choose the angle that you want. You can, if you're using this for a manipulation or composite or something like that, just put the background, put your manipulation on a new layer underneath and just move this around until you match the angle that you need and the lighting. And when you're done, just click this on the 3D tab, click this icon to render, or if you're on the layers tab, right click and choose render 3D, and Photoshop will start to make the calculations. And here on the bottom you will see again how much it takes for the render to finish. Of course, if you have multiple lights and all sorts of shadows and soft shadows, the render time will be longer. And in this case the light is too dim, so we should have used more lights. And also the quality on Photoshop, it's not the same as you will see here. Check it out. Here it's a lot more realistic. If I was to render this in Blender, I would get a much better quality. And in fact, I'm going to do it, and I'm going to just show you the difference between Photoshop and Blender so you can see the difference. Because Photoshop has the render engine is not as powerful as in Blender. So that's all for today. This is what I wanted to show you, how to apply simple textures to UV unwrapped objects in Photoshop. Hope you liked it and see you next time.